So today we're going to talk about everything that you need to do before you hit that launch button on your crowdfunding campaign. And I'm joined today with Alyssa Spector. She was my campaign manager for my crowdfunding campaign. And she's going to talk to us a little bit about everything you need to do to prepare. So thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So let's just get into it. So what are some of the things that artists need to be thinking about as they're kind of in the planning stage of their crowdfunding campaign?
So the most important aspects are having an email list put together and having a solid following on social media and having those outreach numbers. Because ultimately, it's an artist's fans that are going to be involved in their crowdfunding campaign and the ones that are going to contribute. So aside from, you know, the email list and outreach numbers, having all of your assets put together that you're going to be offering in the campaign. So, you know, all the items that you're looking to offer in your store, good high-res promo images of the band, product images, and an intro video. And those are probably the most important components to building out a successful campaign.
Great. So let's talk about the numbers for a second. For example, if an artist was like, okay, my budget is $8,000, but I only have 100 followers, that might not necessarily work, right?
Right. Yeah, we definitely have a formula that we kind of go by. I think initially we usually say, well, it's pretty easy for most artists to raise between $1,000 and $2,000 with just friends and family alone. So that's typically easy, you know, right out of the gates, you know, emerging artists. That's usually an easy target to hit. But for, you know, anything above that, we really look at a formula of about 1.5% of their social media following and 3% of their email list. And we use those numbers sort of generally as a way to guide artists if it seems like an appropriate target or not.
Okay, so if, let's say, hypothetically, if someone's budget was around $5,000, how many kind of followers would you want to see them have, and how many people would you want to see on their email list?
I think at least a few hundred on an email list, so a solid email list. I would say almost about like 500 at least, and you know, at least 1,000 followers on socials, I think, too. But you know, some will surprise us and kind of blow it out of the water, and you know, they reach their target within, you know, a few weeks.
So let's talk a little bit about the merch that people offer. What are kind of some common, really easy things to do that artists can offer in their campaigns?
So of course, you know, we suggest offering the basics: CDs, T-shirts, of course, the digital. And vinyl if you can afford it. And then we also kind of go into unique items as well and experiences. So signed set list, handwritten lyric sheets, maybe a studio hang, attending sound check backstage at a show, maybe the band cooks you dinner, stuff like that.
Because at the end of the day, the people that are, you know, contributing to your campaign really want to feel like they're part of something bigger than just giving that person money, right?
Right.
So I see a lot of campaigns have videos. That's kind of like a huge thing. Whenever you start doing a little bit of research, the first thing that you're going to come across is having a really effective campaign video. Mm-hmm. So can you talk more about that and maybe give us some tips on how to make a good you know, crowdfunding campaign video?
Sure. So the first thing that we suggest is typically to make it short and sweet. So we know that a lot of people have a short attention span. And not only is the video on their project page, but you'll share it on socials, YouTube, et cetera. So you want to make it something that's, you know, exciting enough for people to be into it and engaged within a few seconds. But you also want to kind of reveal the project and what it is that you're trying to do and explain the whole process.
So how long do you think those videos should be, generally speaking?
Usually 30 seconds to like just under 2 minutes, we feel like is the most successful.
That makes sense. Cause you know, Instagram, for example, only has 60 seconds. So I know when I was trying to make my video, I was trying to fit like as much as I could in that first 60 seconds. I think mine was maybe like 90 seconds, mm-hmm. somewhere around there.
Which is perfect, yeah.
Awesome. So do you have any kind of last minute nuggets of wisdom that you'd like to share with people that are kind of thinking about this crowdfunding thing?
My first piece of advice is that it's a lot of work. So you really need to make sure that you have, you know, all of your assets in place and that you do have a fan base there that'll support a project like that.
That is great advice. I'm so grateful to have Alyssa on my team of people that are kind of helping me figure this out as I go. And your advice and your help along the process was just invaluable. So thank you so much for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.